The disciples devoted themselves with one accord to prayer with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brethren. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Your Son to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who have celebrated the Paschal festivities may by your gifts hold fast to them in the way that we live our lives. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Since Paul had appealed to the emperor, Festus sent Paul to Rome. When he came into Rome, Paul was allowed to live by himself with a soldier who was guarding him. 3 days later, he called together the local leaders of the Jews. When they had assembled, he said to them, "Brothers, though I had done nothing against our people or the customs of our ancestors, yet I was arrested in Jerusalem and handed over to the Romans. When they had examined me, the Romans wanted to release me because there was no reason for the death penalty in my case. But when the Jews objected, I was compelled to appeal to the emperor. Even though I had no charge to bring against my people, my nation. For this reason, therefore, I have asked to see you and speak with you, since it is for the sake of the hope of Israel that I am bound with this chain." He lived there for 2 whole years at his own expense and welcomed all who came to him, proclaiming the kingdom of God and teaching about the Lord Jesus Christ with all boldness and without hindrance. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm, our response is, "The just will gaze on your face, O Lord.
The just will gaze on your face, O Lord."
The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold. His gaze examines human beings. The just will gaze on your face, O Lord. The Lord tests the righteous and the wicked, and his soul hates the lover of violence. For the Lord is righteous, he loves righteous deeds. The upright shall behold his face. The just will gaze on your face, O Lord.
as to our room visita, in place pena gracia, que tu creasti pectora, qui diceris par aquitus, altissimi donum Dei, fons vivus ignis caritas, et spiritualis unctio. Tu septis formis munere, digitus paterne dexere, tu rite promissum patris, sermone dintans butura. Ascende lumen sensibus, infunda morem cordibus, infirma nostri corporis, virtute firmans perpeti. Hostem rei pelas longius, pacem quae dones protinus, dutores icte previo, vitemus omni noxio. Per te sciamus ta patra, nascamus aque filius, te quae utrius quae spiritu, credamus omni tempore. Deo Patris sit gloria, et filio qui amor tuis, surrexit ac paraclito, in saeculorum saecula. Amen. Alleluia. The Lord said, I will send you the Spirit of truth, who will lead you to the whole truth. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. After he was raised from the dead, Jesus appeared to the disciples by the Sea of Tiberias and indicated the kind of death by which Peter would glorify God. Peter turned and saw the disciple whom Jesus loved following them. He was the one who had reclined next to Jesus at the supper and had said, Lord, who is it that is going to betray you? When Peter saw him, he said to Jesus, Lord, what about him? Jesus said to Peter, if it is my will that he remains till I come, what is that to you? Follow me. So the rumor spread in the community that this disciple would not die. Yet Jesus did not say to him that he would not die, but if it is my will that he remains until I come, what is that to you? This disciple who testified to these things has written them, and we know that his testimony is true. But there is also many other things that Jesus did. If every one of them were written down, I suppose the world itself could not contain the books that would be written. The Gospel of the Lord. Today is the day before the Feast of Pentecost, and like all feasts in the church, it's important to remember that the graces that flowed once in Pentecost flow today, and that you and I can experience a greater portion of the Spirit as we get ready for this holy feast. Brothers and sisters, filled with paschal joy, let us pray more earnestly to God that he who graciously listened to the prayers and supplications of his beloved Son may now be pleased to look upon us in our lowliness. We pray for our Holy Father Francis, for Pope Emeritus Benedict, for our Bishop Joseph, for their health, intentions, and constant growth in faith, hope, and charity. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, we pray for the grace of a new Pentecost in our lives. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for Father Swan and Father Clinton and Father Mark, whose anniversary of ordination it is today, that God may bless them and keep them faithful to be holy priests after his own heart. For this we pray to the Lord. Mass, we pray in a special way for the recovery of Victoria Hyas. For this we pray to the Lord. In a moment of silence, we offer up our own prayers and petitions. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all the holy souls in purgatory, and we ask them to join us with the saints and angels, especially Saint Joseph, our Blessed Mother, Saint Rita, to pray for more vocations to the priesthood, to the consecrated life, and to holy matrimony, to preserve all those in their vocations, and assist us in our universal call to holiness. For this we pray to the Lord. O God, who knows that our life in this present age is subject to suffering and need, hear the desires of those who cry to you, and receive the prayers of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Holy Spirit come near, we pray, O Lord. Prepare our minds for the divine sacrament, since the Spirit himself is the remission of all sins. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up into heaven in their sight, so that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sings together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, the King. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the face of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Holy Spirit will glorify me, for he will take from what is mine and declare it to you, says the Lord. Alleluia. Let us pray. Hear in your compassion our prayers, O Lord, that as we have been brought from things of past to new mysteries, so with former ways left behind, we may be made new in holiness of mind through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.